What's up, guys? Baxter here, playing Cobalt. Now, I've been following Cobalt for a while now, and I've been always really curious about it. I've only seen very, very little footage and a couple of screenshots and whatnot, so I really, really, really wanted to play it. And for you, those of you who don't know what Cobalt is, it's a game that was made by Oxeye Studios, but is being released distributed by Mojang. And I think Mojang might have a little bit of input on how the game is played, or sorry, how the game is like programmed and whatnot. I'm not 100% sure if they do or not, but I think they are a little bit involved with it, just not that much. Anyway, so I go through these tutorial levels here so I can show you guys how to play if you haven't seen the tutorial yet. This is just alpha. It's version 1.0. Just came out Friday, and I just bought it earlier today, so brand new to it. I'm still a noob. Not that great. The controls are actually pretty hard to get used to. This is a really great aspect of the game here too. You can roll to dodge and deflect enemy projectiles, which is really, really sweet. It just looks like, I don't know, is that the game is so dynamic. It just has so much potential for like really great maneuvering and controlling, and it's just really fun. It's just kind of reminiscent of playing like Super Nintendo or something like that. Playing one of those old Super Nintendo games. So there's three main types of damage that you can deal, which is melee ranged and throwables. As you can see here, the throwables are really, 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 really great. And almost they're needed because some guys are just really, really heavy armored, and you really just need to get that explosion on them. Like I'm shooting grenade launcher there, which is like OP. I've only had it once or twice in the survival mode, which is what I'm going to be playing for you guys coming up. And I've only got it like once or twice because it's kind of hard to live in survival mode. I did get quite a bit of footage, like not that much. I played for about an hour, and just getting used to the controls and stuff. This is actually my first time here going through the tutorial, just reading it and everything. I haven't bought a shield yet in the survival mode, but it looks really great. And here's a little test chamber for everything that you've learned as you go through. This is like my first encounter fighting some guys, and not exactly good. I get blown up there, but that's all right. I'm just starting. The controls are actually kind of difficult to get used to. They're not as easy. It's not as easy to look as it looks. It looks quite like tactical and like, oh, like most people would say, or when they look at it, would be like, oh, yeah, that does look a little bit difficult to control, but I think I can do it, right? It actually does take a little bit of skill. Like it's hard to get used to the controls. I think I've been playing it, like I said, for an hour or two now, and I'm just starting to get used to the controls now, but I still really, really need to practice a bit more. And here I'm just trying to toss a throwable item by following the line here. I kind of gave up on following the line because I figured out the general principle of it, which is just aiming the direction of your roll and then letting go of the item to throw it. You don't really need to follow that exactly, so you can just do something like that. There we go. I just realized that that like red thing is like melting that metal. This is a really cool advanced tactic, advanced punching, where you can punch the ground and double jump across like that. But it's I haven't found it to be very useful in survival mode. You don't really have time to like think about it. There, I do it there, and that actually is a lot more difficult than it seems as well. And this is probably the most difficult thing, and I'm surprised how well I did it when I first tried it, because I came back after, and I just get blown up and like that, just kept blowing up and blowing up and blowing it up. Actually, earlier today, I watched Blue Zephos, aka Simon, play through the tutorial, and one of the main reasons that I bought the game is I know I've been following it for a while, but I watched Simon try and deflect these missiles, and it just made me so mad because he blew up every time and he just wasn't following the instructions. And if Simon ever sees his video, I love your videos, I swear to God, just that was just so frustrating for me. I was like, oh my God, Simon, just listen to the damn instructions. And so I actually bought this game pretty much right after that video, just so I could t see if I could do it. And sure enough, it is actually quite difficult. It's not easy to time because that slow-mo isn't as obvious as you might think it is. So it is kind of difficult, but yeah, I got the hang of it pretty fast. Like I said, though, still not really used to the controls. And that's it for the tutorial, and now I'm going to get into the survival mode here. I think I only include 2 rounds of survival mode, and then at the very end... Oh yeah, I have a really, really large lake spike there. And it goes away. I only have like 2 rounds here. And here I buy the Matter prototype, which does the most damage, I think. I'm pretty sure it does the most damage out of all the beginner guns that you can buy there. But it does have a really low magazine, so... anyways, so what you want to do in survival mode here is... That's a really failed nade throw. What you want to do in survival mode here is you want to kill a bunch of enemies, robots, birds, mushrooms, and whatnot. And then you want to take some random junk. Like, sometimes you'll find, like, robot parts, or you'll find, like, mushrooms and, I don't know, like, bird eggs. And you want to take it back to your, like, junk thing. I don't know what it is. It's like a junk collector. And you get energy points for it. And you can spend these energy points on upgrading your weapon, buying new weapons, buying grenades, buying all kinds of crap, and buying ammo, and stuff like that. One thing I noticed about this game is I really don't like the reloading tactic. I wish I could just reload whenever I wanted to. You might see me a couple of times just shoot my gun, like right here. I shoot it for no reason, just so I can reload. So I'm wasting ammo there, and I don't really like that. Although you do kind of have like a lot of ammo. Actually you don't really have a lot of ammo, but once you accumulate a lot of like energy points, like money, I'll just call it money from here on out and make it simpler. Once you acquire a lot of money, then you can just buy a crap load of ammo, and it really isn't that big of a deal. Anyway, so as you can see, my energy bar underneath Metal Face, which is my character's name, is full, and as I go to the junk collector and gets rid of it, here I buy some ammo for my Matter prototype gun, and buy some stick grenades, because those are really, really, really useful. Extremely useful, actually. You probably couldn't get past the second or third wave without it, for sure. you probably can. Like, just wait until... I'm just going to wait for someone to, like, no-life this game and just become, like, godly at it. And then he's going to release some videos. He or she. I doubt it. Very, very strongly doubt it'd be a girl to do it, but... it's going to make a video of some godlike guy. He's, like, amazing at controlling the guy. Just epic face everywhere. So anyways, here is the second round that I go through again, trying to live and survive. I think the farthest I've ever gotten is just a little bit over 1,000 points. At the very top of the screen, you can see a little lightning bolt there with a 0. That's how many points I have. I've gotten like 1,014 or something like that. That's the farthest I've ever gotten. And I think in this video, I go up to about 500. Which isn't really that far. It is. I don't know. The game's a lot harder than it looks. You have to take my word for it. I highly recommend buying it if you want to. The alpha is only $9.99, and it's a pretty good deal considering the full release is probably going to be about $20. And I'm pretty sure I've read on the website that the beta is when they eventually get up to that stage in development. It's going to be about $15. Similar to Minecraft, obviously. So, if you are curious about Cobalt, go ahead, and I suggest that you buy the Alpha. It helps the producers of the game. It helps them. It gives them some. What's the word I'm looking for? I cannot think of the word right now. It gives them some push to do the game. Some inspiration. It's not the word I'm looking for, but whatever. Anyway, incentives, there you go. It gives them some incentive to keep making the game and finishing the game. They do have some really great plans for it. In this video, I don't show Deathmatch or Capture the Plug, which is like Capture the Flag for this. Multiplayer looks like freaking amazing with this game. I can't wait to play people online with this game. You can do it right now, but I haven't even tried it yet. I'm kind of busy with school at the moment, so haven't really been doing a lot of gaming and crap. One tip, if you ever do decide to buy the game, is rolling is really, really helpful. And rolling is actually a lot harder than I make it look, I think. You can't just roll wherever the hell you want, because when you roll, you can't jump. And you have to actually get really used to the timing and stuff. And, yeah, But anyway, so I've got another full bar here. I'm going to go back to my junk collector and get a whole crap load of monies. And then I'm going to spend it on a Matter Army issue. That's it. So I'm using a Matter prototype gun right now. And the Matter Army issue upgrade that you can buy later on up there is really awesome. There's also a weapon dispenser, like another shop, on top of the middle part in this map. But it doesn't really have that much great stuff in it. I haven't found yet. Like, I haven't really bought any of this expensive stuff there. And here I go by the Matter Army issue. And in this clip, you don't get to see me upgrade it. But that little wrench beside the shop box is to upgrade your weapons. And you can't actually upgrade your Matter prototype, but you can upgrade the military issue Matter, which is, like, frickin' amazing. When I did my 1,000-point run, I had a lot of upgrades on it. I had fully upgraded. It was frickin' awesome. This game's a lot of fun. It gets really hectic, though, and really hard, really fast. This nano shower here, you might have seen me use it earlier on in the little playthrough here, and that's just to heal you up. You don't really have that much life. You get hit a couple times and you're dead, so you got to be careful. And I think that's it for this clip, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video.
No!
And I'll see you next time.
Asshole. We'll be right back.